Wrestling Rampage here, back with another video. Another exciting installment of Wrestling Rampage.
Yes, we are.
Today, we're going to be discussing. Can I go ahead and do the goddamn Vince from 2005 here?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's time to shake things up again! Yeah, after
your shake-up, Vince.
After 9 months instead of a year, after 9 months, we're doing shake-up.
Yeah, I thought they did it every year. Like, you know, that material's been fucked, you know, from the WWF to WWE. WWF, I always shook it up once a year.
Well, I guess they decided that, got a hair there, but I guess they decided that they're going to just shake things up now. Fuck it. But we are the Superstar Shake-Up Review. We're going to give our the review of it and our thoughts. With that being said, I am Joey.
I'm Tommy.
Oh, I'm Thomas. I just think about that right there, review it.
It's not much of a review. No. And as you guys can tell, if you have watched our channel, we did do some live reactions from SmackDown.
We didn't do Raw, because basically I didn't give a fuck.
With that being said,
I'm going to be honest, I'm kind of pissed off at this Superstar fucking weak-ass shake-up.
We'll go ahead and we'll get started with, everybody knows that after WrestleMania, they had some NXT stars make their debuts on, the main roster.
Yeah.
And we'll go ahead and we'll get started with, some of the NXT call-ups that happened after WrestleMania. Which on SmackDown Live, we get, the Perfect 10, Ty Dillinger. Thoughts on that?
I have no problem with it because he's actually over.
Pops.
I had no problem with it. I mean.
I like Ty Dillinger.
I think he's a splendid athlete and going to be a big Raw superstar.
SmackDown.
And then we get the guy who lost at NXT TakeOver Orlando to Bobby Roode. Twice, I might add. But Shinsuke Nakamura.
Yep, on
big
SmackDown.
Big coup for SmackDown.
Yeah, yes, even though SmackDown got the shaft in the Superstar Shake-Up, and I'll mention that right here on the goddamn video. And it's true. But it's good they got Shinsuke Nakamura. He's a big star. Because SmackDown needs more big stars now.
I think it's a big coup. He's really gonna up the ante. I mean, man, you get in the ring with Strong Style. I mean, you really got to up the ante there.
Well, they got two NXT call-ups, and Raw got three.
Of course.
Raw got... We'll start with the lowest.
Of course, Raw gets everything.
205 Live got a new superstar, which, you know, 205 Live is part of the Raw roster. And Odie Lorgan, which was in NXT, performed really good matches. I liked Odie.
He's pretty good. But I think it's a little too early for him to get called up, in my opinion.
I guess they just wanted to put some new guys on 205 Live, I guess. I mean, he is a smaller guy, but I don't really consider him a cruiserweight.
I think it's a little too early for Oney Lorgan, in my opinion.
You don't know that much about Oney
Lorgan. No, I don't know. I don't know. You know, to be honest with you, I don't watch NXT. I watch the pay-per-views. That's about all I do. So I don't know all these guys from NXT.
Elias Sampson.
The Drifter,
who just magically just appeared on there with his goddamn guitar.
Well, he did lose to Cassius Ohno on Loser Leave NXT, but him being on Raw, I could give two fucks. So, I could give two fucks about the Drifter.
I was never a big fan of the Drifter anyway.
I think he sucks.
I never liked him anyway. Come down the pike.
Well, what was that?
It kind of sucks, so I don't care about that.
What was that gimmick? Is that what he does? Just carry around that guitar all the time?
Yeah, with the goddamn dollar bill shoved in the top of like he's a real drifter.
Weren't you trying to be a reincarnation of Jeff Jarrett?
I don't know about that. I remember Jeff just drifting around places.
Jeff stayed in one place, okay.
And then a big coup for Raw. The Revival. Two-time NXT Tag Team Champions.
Yeah, that's a big coup for Raw, but I'd rather see them on SmackDown, in my opinion. Because Raw has enough tag teams as it is. And I'll mention all the fucking shitty tag teams we got on SmackDown now. You know?
Well, you know, there are a lot of tag teams on Raw. I do agree with Tommy.
There's too many.
Here's my fear, and I feared it for every, you know, that if you're not really, you know, if they're not going to push you, I just feel, you know, that you do get lost in the shuffle. And I pray that it just don't happen to the Revival. That's all I'm saying.
They're a great team.
Now, that's why I hate Raw. Everyone they picked out of the main talent on SmackDown is going to get lost in the shuffle. I already see it.
Now we're going to go to Raw first. These are the people that got moved to Raw after the shakeup.
From SmackDown.
From SmackDown. The WWE Intercontinental Champion, Dean Ambrose.
I was pissed off. I didn't want Raw to get no top guy whatsoever. I wanted him to get fucking Zack Ryder or someone like that. No. They get fucking Dean Ambrose, the Intercontinental Champion. But at least SmackDown got something in return, I guess.
I think the big coup for Dean Ambrose to, you know, to go to, you know, to go to, what was the SmackDown, didn't he?
Raw.
No, he's on Raw now.
Well, you see, here's
and he brought the Intercontinental title with him.
Here's my thinking is, you know, they need somebody else there because, you know, he gets thrown in the mix and who knows, you know, there might be a return of, you know.
The Shield?
I don't say that. I say they might return of a feud between Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose.
Dean's a great talent, but I would have rather preferred him on the blue side. I'll be honest with you.
Well, same thing with most of them, right?
Because
here.
He was on Raw there for a little while, and most of the time he just got buried.
He was stagnant.
Bray Wyatt gets moved to Raw.
Yeah.
Top guy on SmackDown.
Yeah.
The former WWE champion.
I'm going to go ahead and say right here he's going to be a lost shuffle like fucking Dean Ambrose is on Raw. That's why I hate fucking Raw.
Bray's going to push aside.
Everyone on Raw. That's why, in my opinion, Raw sucks dick. Because every goddamn talent is fucking under the shuffle. You know, Bray Wyatt was a big-time player on SmackDown. So was Dean Ambrose. And now they're going to be here on Raw. And they're like... And now it all depends on Kurt Angle. But, you know, I have a feeling the way I've been seeing Raw lately, they're going to be lost in the shuffle like everything else.
Well, my opinion of that right there, I don't think it's really going to be Kurt Angle. I think it'll be Stephanie that's the one that's going to push these guys to the side.
So you think Kurt's will... Probably work with him a little bit.
I think Kirk will probably work with him a little bit because Kirk has no talent. Tell this guy, I don't think Stephanie Man knows shit about talent. That's probably how come she married Triple H to try to learn about talent. Well, bitch, you ain't working.
The Miz and Maurice.
They were another top fucking thing on SmackDown.
Dad doesn't believe they were a top thing.
It's fucking true.
I don't think it was a top anywhere.
It was fucking true. They were a big main top on SmackDown. Mm-hmm. And now again, SmackDown loses another top superstar. I was like, oh, I see a bland here. Gonna make SmackDown the bitch, huh? Is that what you want to do, you fucking Raw motherfuckers? I hate Raw.
I'm sorry,
I'm a blue guy through and through. And all these guys that come from SmackDown that's going to go on Raw is going to get lost in the shuffle. Typical Monday Night Raw.
Pops, Miz, and Bruce.
Who's going to miss them?
I am.
Ain't going to be me.
I am. I like the whole Johnson House Rules thing. I'm sorry, Maurice looks hotter than Nikki Bella does. And go back to Dean. I heard this recently that Dean and Renee Young got married. Over the weekend over.
Well, they did. Congratulations to Dean.
You know, congratulations to them. You know, they done it. Like, you should do it.
Mm-hmm.
Not John Cena at WrestleMania. Here's the ring, Nikki. Marry me.
Well, in all basics, it doesn't really matter. You're still going to get fucked. So there you go.
Before Raw even went on air, a couple hours beforehand, you know, they went ahead and started it for some odd reason. And the first one was Apollo Crews.
Yep.
I will say this, though. On Apollo Crews on SmackDown, he wasn't really getting...
Well, he's going to be the same way he was on Raw. So... Mr. Smiley. Mr.
Guy. He needs a gimmick change.
I think of him as Mr. Clean. Because that's all he does is smile.
I think of him as Norman Smiley because that's all Norman Smiley did, is come out there, do a little dance and smile all the time. You got to stop that shit. You got to get some mean in you.
You know, so Apollo Crews to Raw.
I mean, hopefully this gets him somewhere. I mean,
it ain't gonna get him nowhere.
On SmackDown, he wasn't really getting.
But then again, they had
a shorter time frame.
He had an Intercontinental title match. At least he got something.
Yeah, it's SummerSlam.
Well, who cares? He got something. He ain't gonna get nothing here on fucking
Big
Ass Raw.
And he got ran over.
Kalisto.
Who cares?
Well, this is a big coup for 205 Live to get a good cruiserweight.
Well, see, he wasn't doing nothing on SmackDown Live.
Exactly.
And he ain't going
to
I thought
it was shitty for him to go to SmackDown to begin with.
Well, goddamn.
We got the cruiserweights on Raw.
Well, yeah. just wait until we get to SmackDown. We got some cards for no reason.
So who cares?
I don't.
Pops, please though.
He's just...
He'll probably just be there.
He's just going to be a 205 Live guy that barely people watch.
Gonna be Odie Lorgan, huh?
Yeah, he's gonna be Odie Lorgan.
If I had a chance to get a payday and not do anything, fuck it, I'll take that bet.
Heath Slater and Rhino.
I'm pissed.
The first ever SmackDown tag team.
Well, they kind of been stagnant.
They have been stagnant since their run
after their
title run.
When they won the first SmackDown tag team champions.
But they had a good thing going with Heath Slater,
yeah.
You know, him being the trailer park guy.
Yeah, I liked Heath Slater and Rhino, and I'm kind of pissed off that they're on got switched up to Raw, because who does SmackDown get, you know? Enough said.
Rhino, Heath Slater.
You don't
like Heath Slater.
But you like Rhino.
I'll just say Rhino, okay, because Heath Slater ain't nothing but a piece of shit. My grandson could beat up Heath Slater.
Yeah, I like Heath Slater and Rhino.
But, you know, I don't think that they're really going to do much with them because you know, they've already had their run, and as little as it may have been, I don't think that you'll get another run at anything.
A big coup for Raw. They got one of the top women two top women on SmackDown. Mm-hmm. Let's just go ahead and say this. Alexa Bliss, two-time SmackDown Women's Champion, and Mickie James.
Yeah, I was pissed off about that as well.
They both go to Raw.
I was pissed off about that.
And then you leave
Raw.
All the shitty fucking.
And who do we have? We have fucking Carmella still. And the only people that I think are any good on fucking SmackDown, you know, Naomi is in okay status right now. Mm-hmm. But the only ones that could actually fucking work is Becky Lynch and Natalya. So, I was hoping and praying that we get another good goddamn worker on SmackDown, or two of them at least. But
Alexa Bliss and Mickie James go to Raw.
Yeah. Two good fucking talents from SmackDown.
You know, I'm kind of upset because I'm an Alexa Bliss fan. And
you're going to have to watch a 3-hour fucking Raw to fucking see her.
Even watch that, Pops.
I think you know, because I like watching Alexa Bliss too. But,
I'm just sorry. Like every time I watch Raw, it's just they always make stupid ass mistakes.
Alexa Bliss, Mickie James.
I think that they're gonna be maybe a big deal there, but somehow or another, I just don't believe so.
Let me guess. You have a feeling that Mickie James and Alexa Bliss gonna be lost in the show.
I think that they're just gonna be, you know.
That's where I think of most of these people.
Go to the back seat. We'll call you when we need you for something big.
Big coup for Raw right here, guys. Biggest the steal of the night. Kurt Hawkins to Raw from SmackDown Live.
Who cares? Who cares? Like, who the fuck cares about Grimm's butt buddy? Because I don't. And all I remember is he came out on Raw and said, "Yeah, I'm the new draft pick." And all I remember, Big Show just punched him and he laid down.
Pops, the MVP of the shakeup.
Fucking cheap accordion.
The MVP of the shakeup, Kurt Hawkins, what do you think?
Who really gives a shit about Kurt Hawkins?
I didn't give a shit about him his first run.
What the hell is he even doing?
A fuck about him on SmackDown. So why do you think I'm going to give a fuck about him when he's coming on Raw?
But better get out and get another job, because you sure the fuck ain't making it a wrestler, motherfucker.
And we get announced team switch.
Yeah.
David Otunga gets moved to Raw, and SmackDown gets Byron Saxton.
You just traded another shitty announcer for another shitty announcer.
Yeah, they just might
look only thing I'm going to have to do is hear David Otunga on Raw. And of course, I got to hear fucking Byron Saxton on SmackDown. Two wrestlers that couldn't fucking hack it. Well, that's true.
Where's Jim Ross at? Jim Ross signed the deal. Where's Jim Ross?
Yeah, bring Jim Ross on that. Actually, fuck, I don't give a damn if JBL bullied more or now. Bring him back. Fuck. Because I'm telling you, these announcers are fucking drizzling fucking shits. Even Michael Cole's starting to become shit. Like, they're all just fucking talking like a fucking computer. You know, Braun Strowman lifted the ambulance. My God.
With the greatest of ease.
Like, they don't get shit over.
Otunga and Saxon, Dad.
Well, what's the sense in changing them, too? They're both pieces of shit. They were
the shittiest announcers on the team anyway. And
you was trade another shitty announcer for another shitty one.
Why change shit to shit? You know, you're not getting anything except another piece of shit.
Yeah.
God.
SmackDown Live. SmackDown Live gets some draft picks as well. We get Tamina. Tamina Snuka.
I was waiting for Sasha Banks. Or fuck.
Well, see, they built it up like Charlotte was about to come out.
Yeah.
And then like,
yeah, they're about to.
Tamina. And I'm like,
I was like, really? I was pissed. Like, I was like, really? That's a waste of
day. Yeah, you can watch it on YouTube. We got a reaction video of that. It's on the channel.
I hated it. I was thinking Sasha Banks. I was thinking fucking someone. Someone that was fucking good. To me, the Snuka is not no good worker. I'm sorry.
That's a waste of girl. But right there.
It was.
I was like, because I ain't seen her for a while. Who the fuck is this?
There you go. I never really thought she was that great of a worker anyway.
Nope.
So, with her coming to SmackDown, who gives a shit?
Yeah, who gives a shit?
So we lost two top talents on SmackDown to Raw to get one shitty one from. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then we get Lana.
Well, I enjoyed that goddamn fucking...
The video package...
That video package is fucking hot.
With her doing this old striptease on the chair, I was digging that.
Oh, I was digging that. When she was coming to SmackDown, I was like, got no problem with it now.
Hopefully, she just dances with the chair.
Yeah. Yeah, because that was fucking her. That was fucking great.
But, Pops Lana.
We got me. That striptease was really good.
Stripper with a chair.
No, that was great, wasn't it?
I mean,
that's the only thing I enjoyed.
And then coming to SmackDown Live, I was like, well.
Hopefully you don't.
Hopefully you keep dancing, baby.
Hopefully you just keep
dancing.
Because
that's all the talent you got, bitch.
And, of course, a big coup for SmackDown. You know, we lost two top talents to Raw.
But at least we get
SmackDown them. Gets a one of the biggest stars that came from Raw and Charlotte Flair.
Oh, I loved it.
Yeah.
I loved it. It's like, finally, we've got another good worker. Can we get rid of Tamina? I didn't give a fuck. I would have traded Tamina for Nia Jax if I had a choice.
Well, see, I was looking for Charlotte Flair to go to SmackDown.
Well, I'm glad she's on SmackDown.
Because she got squashed by Nia Jax. Her run on Raw was... You could tell her run on Raw was over.
Yeah,
well, she done everything on Raw.
Exactly. It was... Yeah.
I'm glad Charlotte... Charlotte's on SmackDown.
Four-time women champion.
I was like, holy shit, we hit the jackpot. And so far, we haven't been hitting the jackpot. So I was like, holy shit. It's almost like ECW. We got Matt Hardy. You know.
Pop Charlotte Flair going to SmackDown.
Here's the thing. I have to laugh at this. I mean, I'm glad, you know, because Charlotte to me was, you know, on Raw, she was getting stagnant there. I mean, she did everything that she could probably do. And I'm glad she's on SmackDown. But look, I'm sorry. You got the Glow Girl.
Naomi.
That is the World Heavyweight Champion.
The Women's Champion.
What do you think is going to happen?
She is not going to beat
What do you think is going to happen when Charlotte goes against her? Well, I'm going to be totally honest with you.
I'm looking forward to the matches with Becky Lynch with Natalya.
The only thing that Charlotte's going to have trouble with is going to be Becky Lynch and Natalya. The rest of those, she's going to scoot through them. I tell you what. If Charlotte gets a title shot with the Glow Girl having the title, you can look for yourself on women's...
Naomi?
The Glow Girl, I call her, because I don't see nothing fantastic about she comes out dancing the bullshit.
Well, speaking of nothing fantastic, we got the Shining Stars to SmackDown Live.
Yeah, you heard my fucking opinion when you hit that record button. This ain't even worth recording. I was like this. We get Heath Slater and Ryan, we get the fucking Shining Stars of the Caribbean. Why the fuck do we want Primo and Epico on our fucking roster? I was like, God damn, you got so many goddamn tag teams on Raw. You could have gave us an Enzo teams. And Kaz. Or
the New Day comes to SmackDown as well.
Well, at least we get one good fucking tag team. But here's the thing. New Day's stagnant nowadays.
They lost twice to the Revival.
Am I happy they're on SmackDown Live? Yeah. But here's the thing. Yeah, they were longest reigning WWE tag team champions. But what have they done lately?
Lose and Kofi gets his ankle broken. There you go.
But I'm glad they're on SmackDown Live because we need more tag teams. But I don't like the Shining Stars Caribbean being on that bitch.
Shining Stars, New Day.
I'll just sum it like this. Who cares?
There we go.
You gotta admit, at least the New Day's better than the Shining Stars.
I wouldn't give neither one the fart.
Yeah, of course you won't.
Because I hate both of them.
We got three people that got changed, that is shown, they didn't come out or nothing. And it is Jinder Mahal.
Well, actually, he did come out.
Well, afterwards.
He took on Mojo Rawley, and of course, after
they announced him, he was part of the
whole thing. I guess they traded Curt Hawkins for Jinder.
Hinder Jinder's going to SmackDown.
And again, I don't...
So he go against Gronk again.
So who gives a fuck? I wasn't too happy that we got Jinder Mahal. I was like, oh, so we just traded Jobber Curt Hawkins for another Jobber, huh?
Well, speaking of another Jobber, we got Sin Cara.
Well, see, I guess they traded Kalisto for Sin Cara. I don't know if it's a trade, but that's how I feel it. You get the other Lucha Dragon. What's Sin Cara going to do anyway?
And then we got injured reserve right now. Rusev is on...
Yeah, he's on injury right now.
Yeah.
Which, I like Rusev. He's getting stagnant there on Raw.
Yeah, teaming up with Jinder.
He's got Jinder here, but I don't think he's going to be teaming with Jinder here.
Here soon, I think Rob Gronkowski will be on SmackDown with his little shitty fucking... Yeah. Stay Hype shirt.
Yeah. I think he's the only Mojo Rawley fan in my
opinion. Oh, he's the next one's going to the Hall of Fame?
Probably.
For
throwing a beer and doing a
beer!
A football tackle.
But here's the thing. Rusev, he was getting stagnant on Raw. So maybe here on SmackDown, he can get a little bit of a push. Because SmackDown
Sin Cara
is...
and Jinder Mahal.
Well, see, Sin Cara and Jinder Mahal.
Don't really give a shit about neither one of them.
What about Rusev?
Don't give a fuck about Rufus.
Rufus?
Because he belongs on the fucking roof, and I like to push him off of one.
I like Rusev, but,
hopefully he gets a big push here on SmackDown.
Handsome Rusev. Yeah. Well, that's what he went by on Raw. Don't be looking at me like...
I've seen him. Did he ever look at his fucking self in the mirror?
Well, hopefully here on SmackDown he can get a push.
Two big stars. Last and least right here.
Yeah.
Sami Zayn. Even though Kurt Angle said Sami ain't going nowhere, but he went. Sami Zayn goes to SmackDown.
We'll see.
And we get United States Champion Kevin Owens.
Oh, Kevin Owens on...
With the shaved beard.
Oh, yeah, he was clean shaven. I enjoyed that Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are on SmackDown. Because now maybe Sami Zayn will be used properly. And you might as well say, straight out the gate, he was used properly.
Yes, he was.
He was in the number one contenders match for the United States title. Of course, he lost, but at least he was used properly.
Yeah, yeah.
In the main event on SmackDown. Mm-hmm. I don't remember Sami Zayn main event anything on Raw lately.
Nope.
You know, that's what I'm saying, Raw. The guys that came from SmackDown to Raw are going to get lost in the goddamn shuffle.
Pops, last and not least, Kevin Owens, United States Champion, and Sami Zayn.
Oh, my hell.
They're top picks, pretty much, besides Charlotte.
Who would not want, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn? Who would not want them? God damn, I had a chance to grab them, too, in a heartbeat.
So let's say, we'll go ahead and say is Kevin Owens, Sami Zayn, and Charlotte Flair were the MVPs coming to SmackDown. The rest was pretty much...
Exactly.
With Rusev and the New Day, I'd put them mid-card level.
Yeah.
And then the rest of them were garbage.
Yeah.
And you know, I totally agree with both of you guys about this.
Here's something I'm going to say. It looks to me Vince really wanted to prove to make SmackDown the minor league.
You can actually tell Vince is like, we want all the stars to be on Raw.
Exactly.
He took all the fucking A players... that were on SmackDown and brought them to Raw. Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose, The Miz.
The only one he kept was AJ Styles, Randy Orton.
The Miz, fucking, who else?
And John Cena too, but John Cena's about to lose a fucking shitty movie.
You know, they
and
took
then Raw.
Here's the thing, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but here's the thing. You know how come... but Vince could get rid of AJ Styles because AJ Styles now is in bread and butter, motherfucker. Eat your bread and fucking butter.
On SmackDown.
You know, fucking Raw took all the SmackDown A players. Bray Wyatt.
Dean Ambrose, Bray Wyatt.
Miz, no, I do agree.
Alexa Bliss.
I do agree.
Mickie James.
Yeah,
And then the rest was pretty much just stagnant.
Oh, the rest was stagnant, but they took a big chunk.
So they got five good players.
And Raw only get and SmackDown only, basically only get four.
I say three.
Three. It don't fucking matter. And of course you got Shinsuke Nakamura and Ty Dillinger. But here's the thing: Ty Dillinger ain't ready yet. He's still in that. But Shinsuke Nakamura, yes, he's a big star. So I'll give that a four.
So with that being said, I believe SmackDown got shafted.
I believe Vince put his dick. And fucking mates and put it right in SmackDown Live's asshole.
So
you know, and it kind of pisses me off because I think Vince was so pissed off that SmackDown was drawing better ratings than what Raw was.
You know, he can't let his little girl go down the drain.
He can't let his main show Raw lose a little bit.
But that was the superstar shakeup.
Man, shit anyway.
I call it a superstar fuckdown is what I call it.
But with that being said, don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Follow us on Twitter @WrestleRampage. Also, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And also, feel free to give us your guys' input on who you think was good for SmackDown and who you think was good for Raw.
Yeah.
We'd like to hear it.
Maybe your input's different than ours, you know?
Yeah, maybe you like the Raw. That me, Raw's bitch.
Well, you go ahead and take us out, Tyler.
If you don't subscribe right here on Wrestling Rampage, where the fuck have you been?